Jeff Santos Show on the Revolution Radio Network. Rebuilding America together. Now, here's Jeff.
Thank you, Ron, and good afternoon, Americans, and welcome to the Jeff Santos Show. It is great to be with you. We got ourselves a fantastic show today. Again, jam-packed. We're going to start with our good friend, Mark Taylor-Canfield will be with us, and we will talk to MTC and all about what is happening, tragically enough, and the Amazon workers being outdueled, outspent, basically cheated by Amazon. Nothing new there. We'll get his thoughts on the Seattle-based company, the number two company in the entire country in terms of employees. Second, we will go to our good friend Bob Cusack on all things The Hill. Joe Biden once again caving to Joe Manchin, caving to special interests. This is not what we expected and what we want as progressives. When you got to fight for what we want, not going to get everything, but certainly don't want to be shut out of an infrastructure bill that even Rob Scott, who works very closely with a lot of his former teammates, if you might, now at the White House, very discouraged by going from $6 trillion to $3 trillion, now to $2 trillion, or 2.2. Not good. So we'll get into that with Bob Cusack and get the latest on what is going on the Hill. From the Hill. At 4 o'clock, our great Harvey Kay will stop by for the entire hour. He is fuming, if you've been following him on Twitter, at Harvey Kay. It is, again, folks, an opportunity here for Joe Biden to be a miniature, and I say miniature, FDR, and he's blowing every opportunity at it, particularly the situation with Manchin and the filibuster. He knows, the Biden administration knows, that without the filibuster, they're toast. The party is toast, and you might as well say goodbye to 2022, because without the African-American vote, without the Latino vote, without the Asian vote, without young white voters, you can say goodbye, and the Republicans have targeted him in over 40 states. So there you go. It's there, all in black and white, and the Democratic Party, the clock is ticking. Tick, 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 tick. Okay, at that point, we'll talk to a future progressive star. He's going to be governor of California at some point, whether it's in the next couple of years or future, but he is the great Joe Sandberg. If you want to find out more about him and aspiration.com, go to aspiration.com/revolution. He comes up at 5 o'clock Eastern time to Pacific. And we'll wrap it up with our old friend. Those of you who are hockey fans, the NHL trade deadline is on Monday. So we brought back our great friend Doug McLean, former NHL coach with the Florida Panthers and the NHL general manager and coach of the Columbus Blue Jackets. Of course, we are always excited about hearing from all of you at jeff@revolutionboston.com. You can email me, jeff@revolutionboston.com. And of course, at Jeff Santos Show on both Facebook and Twitter as well. We are going to talk with our great friend Mark Taylor-Canfield in a few seconds. We want to hear from you, of course, today at 772-223-2362. That's 772-223-2362. Let's bring in the aforementioned Renaissance man of the Jeff Santos Show. He's a great musician. He's a great investigative journalist. He's a great advocate for all things progressive. He is indeed MTC, and he joins us on the line from the great 206 in Seattle. Mark, thank you for adjusting your schedule today. We appreciate it. And what's going on with the Amazon workers, and how are you doing?
That was for Jimmy.
There you go.
I know Jimmy. Whenever we get feedback on a guitar accidentally in the studio or during a show, somebody always yells out, "Jimmy's in the house!"
That's right. Jimmy rocks. So the Seattle native, Jimi Hendrix, the greatest guitarist of all time. So,
If it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be doing what I'm doing. Hey, yeah. I'm sorry. It's cool that we're doing this earlier, but you did catch me after a late night. So, you know how musicians and journalists have these lifestyles where you never know when you're going to actually get some sleep. But I did get some sleep. I was able to sleep in a little bit, which is really nice. But it's been one of those weeks where you go, what have I been doing? You're so busy that you know, my job as a journalist never slowed down, and now the stuff with the music is picking up, so it's, you know, it's been a busy time. I actually want to take a little time off and do more music and just kind of relax a little bit, because like my dad was saying, you know, if you got to enjoy the fruits of your labor occasionally. And I realized this week I've just been working. Chris, I know you do the same thing every day on this program, so you know exactly what I'm talking about.
Oh yeah.
But at some point on the weekends, you got to get away, you know, and get some R&R. So I hope you get a chance to do that too this week, because I know you.
I'm looking forward to the weekend and more of the ways than you can imagine. MTC. So you know you have Seattle's a great city for protest, and I was actually hoping you get the All-Star game, but Denver got it. So I thought it would be really a great way to show the rest of the country that you know how to vote, and you've been doing it pretty well for a long time. Plus, you have a baseball park and the great. Now in a stadium. But, I, you know, it's well known for protest, and there's two big issues today. Of course, Amazon and the Floyd Chauvin trial going on in Minnesota. A lot of people, presumably, in Seattle who are marching out there for civil rights and racial justice, as well as for better working conditions at Amazon. How are those two intersecting in your favorite city?
DSA, the Democratic Socialists of America, had a big rally last week at the Amazon Spheres. And so that was something that I was covering as a journalist. Actually, that's been going on for the last 2 weeks. And, you know, these are both really, really high-profile issues in Seattle, only because there's been a series of marches and protests in solidarity with both of these issues, one with the trial over the death of George Floyd. So, of course, the news from the, you know, there's testimony going on right now as we speak, but the testimony yesterday, I think the prosecution's argument was kind of blown out of the water by some of that testimony. So that was really a hard thing to sit through, but at the same time, you know, it's important information. So there was a march here on the 300th day after George Floyd's death, and there are marches going on a regular basis. And every Thursday, the Black Action Coalition is out marching. They actually marched in solidarity and postponed their march on Thursday to allow for the Amazon march to happen. So those two groups have actually kind of been working together on some of these issues. But, you know, when it comes to Amazon, I mean, they have over 75,000 employees in Seattle. So it's like, as I say, when Jeff Bezos sneezes, you know, the whole city shifts. And I'm as a journalist, you know, it's one of the reasons why you get a lot of work as a journalist in Seattle is because you have these major corporations like Microsoft, which has been here for a long time, of course, Boeing, which has been here even longer. And you've got Starbucks, Google has now moved a lot of their corporate headquarters here. Although, I have to tell you, there's at least two major buildings near downtown that have Google on them, you know, and it looks like the Google icon that you see on your search engine all the time. But I haven't seen anybody really in those buildings, so I don't think they've ever actually been opened. I think the construction slowed down and everything, just slowed everything down. I don't think Google is actually peopling those buildings with employees, at least nobody that I've seen. And they're quite substantial, big buildings. It was also where a crane accident took place while they were building it. So, and that was really tragic. You know, that was something I also reported on because I was like a block away when this crane fell over. But, you know, it's what makes Seattle Seattle is that we have this very progressive city government, very progressive city council, and then you have these corporate interests. So it's a constant battle. And to see what happened in Amazon, you know, in Alabama, to some folks here, of course, because they've been out holding solidarity marches and speaking in favor of unionization in Alabama. Well, you know, we have to remember that it's not the most union-friendly part of the country, you
That's
know,
right.
or even part
That's
of
right.
the state. So
and there were a lot of, there seemingly,
battle.
According to both the L.A. and New York Times, there were a lot of hanky-panky going on in that vote. And the union folks, Mr. Applebaum, I believe his name is Stuart Applebaum, was one of the union leaders on this, is going to look to take a lot of this to court because he doesn't believe it really was a fair vote. So not surprised. I mean, you know, this is, again, after all, Amazon, which is not exactly, you know, the saint for human rights and pay equity in this world. So not unexpected, but, you know, sad that we you think there would be an honest vote here, but not in 2021.
They've been accused of using propaganda in the bathrooms and all sorts of things, and literally even like getting the city to change the timing of a stoplight so that fewer people could stop and talk to the picketers, things like that. So,
wow.
Yeah, Amazon is big, and when they want to influence local politics, they do. And I guess it's back, you know, in the tradition of the big railroad and oil tycoons, the J.P. Morgans of the world, who, you know, could just kind of come into town and dictate what goes on. And that's the tycoon baron. We were talking about this Democracy Watch News the other day too, about this sort of idolization of the billionaires and how that's really, I think, messed up our culture. You know, I mean, if that's what people think is the most important value in your society, then you really need to rethink your value system, because we have people out there living in tents under bridges in every city in the country, every major city at least. And I don't even hear the Democrats really talking much about that, Jeff, at least not in the White House.
Yeah, and of course, over the last 40 years, to your point, we've had, shows like The Lifestyles of the Rich and Famous with Robin Leach, and that's what people get excited about. It's this individual, over-the-top wealth, as opposed to providing a foundation for everybody. It's a selfishness, it's about me first, and I think that we've had politicians from both parties, frankly, who have, you know, basically allowed Wall Street, allowed that kind of mentality to continue. And I think you're exactly right. And a lot of the people on the streets in Seattle have actually, you know, gone against that and have begun protests and have begun, you know, that's why I think that the All-Star Game should have been there, because you guys have begun so many things. The $15 minimum wage and SeaTac. You look at what you did with, the first state with marijuana legalization. You can go on and on and on. You know, I'm not saying that Colorado hasn't been a state that's been a leader either, but you guys, and particularly in the 206, have been tremendously progressive, and hopefully you can dethrone Mr. Amazon on top of it.
I'm hoping that people will pick up on this idea of publicly funded city elections, because we do have this democracy voucher system in Seattle where they send everybody, every registered voter, four $25 vouchers, and you can spend those on any campaign you want. So it's all publicly funded. And I know Colleen Echohawk, the Native woman who's running for mayor, is holding all sorts of, not only town hall meetings, her staff told me that she has over 40 of them planned, and that's amazing. But that's kind of a Pramila Jayapal approach, where you just have town hall meetings all the time, and you're always talking to people in the community and always talking to your constituents. There's that, a good grassroots organization, and also she's out having online house parties with the democracy voucher holders and treating them like big paid donors, and having, you know, special online events for them and things. So it's kind of funny, because those people that have the $100 vouchers are just as important to her as, you know, somebody on a national level would be, you know, with some multi-millionaire or billionaire CEO of a corporation. You know, it kind of levels the playing field, equalizes things a little bit, and gives you an idea of what politics looks like when you don't have millions of dollars involved. Speaking of that, I have to throw this out, you know, Amazon employs over 950,000 full-time and part-time workers in the United States, and a million, and almost, you know, 1.3 million worldwide. So you can see why they might have an overreaching influence on not only the markets, but also the politics. And we're still fighting them in Seattle. We haven't given in. We did get a corporate tax. We did get the $15 an hour minimum wage out there. And there has been pressure on Amazon to reform some of its practices, and there has been some success in doing that. It's a slow road to hoe, because a tough road to hoe, because Jeff Bezos is a true libertarian who really doesn't think that he owes the community anything.
Yeah. before we go here, in a couple of things, how are people reacting to the Chauvin trial? Obviously, this has been an issue that a lot of people have gotten engaged with on the streets. What's the latest on that?
People are just watching the trial, and there have been the regular marches that have been happening anyway to mark that issue. So expect to see marches. I mean, that's Seattle. You always see marches. And I don't see the police really escorting them and blocking traffic for them anymore. So they have to kind of do their own parade marshaling and stuff. But, yeah, expect to see that. And expect to see more marches against Amazon for various reasons. But I'm actually hoping that the music scene is going to come back here, because I've been, you know, I have this EP that is ready to release. So,
right. I know you want to get out there, man, and maybe you can get a rooftop to
check out my videos on YouTube. I did a tour of my studio there. See you next time.
It's MTC, Mark Taylor Canfield. Check it out on Twitter, on Facebook. We'll be right back with Bob Cusack of The Hill. You're listening to The Jeff Santos Show.